Philo and Sophia combine denote love for knowledge in English. In broad terms. There they go. Philo's love, and Sophia, knowledge. It's a like a love story, in which there are elements of awe, amazement, curiosity, respect for everything there is, contemplation, skepticism, ideals, ideas, things in themselves, notions, principles, axioms, maxims, categories, logic, phenomenon, accidents, systems, determinism, causality, symmetry, syllogisms, authority, hierarchy, religion and more. When you study philosophy, you feel as if you were climbing the shoulders of a giant. It would be wonderful to have and keep this view from above. Western philosophy has its origins in ancient Greece. If you take a look at the world map, you can see what's is going on in this specific region. Greece, it was more or less Hellas and Turkey combined, is in contact with the near, neighboring East. This explains a lot in philosophy. There has been a historical commerce between these two regions, not only of goods, but a commerce of ideas and also, worldviews. This becomes clear when you study history of philosophy. Ancient schools of thought comprise Stoicism, Epicureanism, Cynicism, Skepticism, Platonism, Neoplatonism. And, of course, we have the Aristotelian school. These are the daughters of the Socratic school and influence to this day the study of morality, epistemology, emotions, logic, etc. Here, there is contemplation, but first and foremost these schools offered a way of life and a way to look at things. Often they praised practical life, not only contemplative studies. Pierre Hadot, 1922-2010, is a renowned Hellenist and has done a wonderful work in translating and forwarding to us the core elements in ancient philosophy. Philosophy today is mostly produced in philosophy departments of universities around the world. I would say that those who can be considered philosophers are very specialized in their fields and are very prolific when it comes to writing and publishing. I dare to say that we may learn a lot in philosophy just by choosing any philosopher and by trying and establishing a dialogue with him, her. Heidegger, Nietzsche, Kant, Machiavelli, Hume, Locke, John Stuart Mill, Hegel, Marx, Hobbes, Kierkegaard, Rousseau, Plato, Aristotle, Seneca, Adorno, Walter Benjamin, Simone de Beauvoir, Hannah Arendt, Marcus Aurelius, Cicero, Epicuro, Sartre. Chomsky, Bernard Williams, Harry Frankfurt, Korsgaard, John Rawls, Thomas Nagel, and the list goes on. Philosophy comes from the Greek roots, philosoph, meaning, love of knowledge. Philosophy, to put it simply, is thinking about the big important stuff. Philosophy is centered around questions. What is the meaning of life? What is the best way to live? What is right and wrong? Am I just a brain in a vat? What is knowledge, and how am I supposed to know what it is? How should we live as a society? Is the mind part of the body, or separate from it? What even is? All of these questions are part of philosophy, which is a very broad subject that includes many other things. For example, science is philosophy. Religion is philosophy. Political theories are philosophy. But there isn't a limit to what philosophy can be, as long as it's something you're thinking about. Philosophy is characterized by thinking, especially critical thinking, which is the rational and careful analysis of things to form judgments. You don't need a degree to be a philosopher. In fact, you, who ask this question, are a philosopher. By asking what philosophy is, and especially by asking why it is important, you are philosophizing. It's as simple as wondering about things. When you are curious and ask questions about reality, value, meaning, etc., you are practicing philosophy. So why is it important? Because philosophy is how our species has come this far, from the Stone Age to the Information Age. Without philosophy, we would have no logic, science, or reason. We wouldn't have any government other than dictatorship by a self-proclaimed God-king. We wouldn't be able to predict the weather, which is what Thales, the first known philosopher, did and managed to show up the smoothsayers. We wouldn't have medicine, as the beginnings of medicine were founded on philosophy. We wouldn't even have books without philosophy. We would be nothing more than mostly hairless primates. Philosophy means thinking, and thinking about thinking. As Socrates, the greatest philosopher of all time, once said, "The unexamined life is not worth living. Question everything, especially your own beliefs and assumptions. Keep on thinking. Dive straight into the mystery of existence without fear."